Big Ideas at Queen's College.
I like to look at very interesting phenomena, figure out what could be happening under the hood at a molecular level, and then I also feel that it's very helpful in communicating it if I can tie it to some sort of common language that we're all familiar with. Thankfully, Disney and Marvel have done a pretty good job of creating that common social language that revolves around their movies. If you can imagine how a radioactive spider could bite Peter Parker and turn him into Spider-Man, you have to start thinking, okay, well, now that he's stronger, we have to assume that his muscle systems have changed. How could we change the cells that make up a muscle or the proteins that are coded inside those cells that allow them to be super powerful? DNA itself can be modified with these chemical residues called methyl groups. And then we look at how that DNA actually wraps up around these proteins called nucleosomes. And depending on how each of these things collect different chemical modifications, it changes the way genes get expressed. We have some projects that are looking at the way a fish changes color and changes its behavior and how both changes are intertwined with one another. This model system is a fish that has two types of males. They have a dominant male and a subordinate male. Dominant male, super aggressive, he has bright, vibrant colors, he gets to court, and then there's the subordinate male who doesn't get to do any of these things. He's very meek, he hides, he has no colors. And what was really cool is that if you put a large subordinate next to a smaller dominant, their behaviors would change over the course of a few seconds to minutes. Their physiology would change over the course of hours, and over the course of weeks, there would be all kinds of anatomical changes that happen in their brain. I thought that was a very powerful system that we could do a lot of studies related to this field of epigenetic changes. Good science, it's a combination of an important question, it's a combination of a relevant approach, but it's also a little bit of creativity. For example, the fish that I was talking about, the cichlid, it's like the Incredible Hulk. He goes from this very meek, uncolorful male to this incredibly aggressive, super bright colored. I mean, he changes color like the Hulk. He changes his behavior like the Hulk. A lot of the science fiction work that we do helps us get creative. We're not gonna ask whether this is possible based off the writing that a creative has come up with. We know that it's fictional, but we have to make it real.
Big Ideas at Queen's College is a Queen's College production.